If you have your Bibles, you will turn with me to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 22, and verse number 30. Say amen when you have it. Say amen when you have it. Help me, Lord, if you're still looking for it. Amen. Go on and preach if you just want me to go on and preach. Amen. I actually did the work on this text the last time we had a 100-man rally, and Jason, get a count of how many men are here today, so we'll know. We didn't get a total count of how many people are here today. Praise God, and get the acronym and pull them. But then the background work, which I told you, the adultery that was taking place, and how men had turned their backs on God in large proportion of numbers, and how people were just basically worshiping any kind of way they wanted to worship. And God did not accept it then, and does not accept it now. You can hold your spot at Exodus 4 and verse 25, Exodus 4, 25. And so because of the atmosphere that is going on, it seemed that everybody was out of their place. It seemed that there was no standard for God in doing these days, and that it was just kind of any idol worship that wanted to take place, took place. Similar to would be this morning. There is no longer, it seems to be no longer a standard in which folk worship God according to His Word. But now it's whatever church you want to go to, you just get up and you go to that church, and you dare anybody to say something to you about it. In fact, during these times, the prophets were even murdered and killed because they preached the kingdom of God, killed, and they were under duress and pressure. It is under this context in which the Almighty God has Ezekiel's prophet to preach. And he preaches, and in verse number 30, he says that I saw a man. Now think about this for a minute. The God of heaven says, I saw a man. God said, I saw a man that would make up the hedge. Now listen to this. Make up the hedge and stand in the gap. Okay. God saw a man. Then. And I believe that God is seeking man now.
Amen.
To make up the hedge and to stand in the gap. How is it that the God of heaven has to look for a man? All seeing and all knowing finds himself looking for a man. Because there is a difference in a man and a boy. Perhaps he saw some men who were caught up in themselves that were declassified, unworthy to be used in his service, caught up in envy and jealousy and rage and selfishness. Let me pre-qualify before I start. When I preach this lesson, I'm not chauvinistically preaching this lesson because I don't believe that all men are godly men.
Amen.
God seeks a godly man to do godly things. And he expects the godly man to stand his ground. In the midst, if the whole world turns its back against God and don't nobody give him glory, God expects the man of God to give him glory. In the face of every enemy that the Jews face, God expects a man to stand his ground and give God glory. This lesson is not referring to abusive men. It's not referring to verbally abusive men. It's not referring to men who abuse the power that God has given them. But it is a lesson that is referring to remind men of who they are in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
And you got to be a man nowadays because it seems like the world, as it did, has turned its back on God. And it seems like men have left a community environment, have become individualistic, and have gone about their own business and left the ways of God. Watch, if you will, we're reminded that God said, I saw the man. The question that came to me is, where are all the men? You remember last time I told you that women outnumber men 3-1 in the church. You might want to know that the Bureau, the U.S. Bureau of Census reports that in fact, that there is a disproportionate of number of men to the tune of about 18 million households that were added to the Bureau of single households with no men in them, which means that the number of households that were headed by women alone increased in 2009 by 18 million families. Where are all the men? Well, they're not in the homes raising their children. They're not in the educational system, because Forbes magazine researchers came about and looked at the economical picture as far as the wage between men and women, and they have found that even amongst the collegiate students, that women are outnumbering men to the tune of 70% to 30%, meaning that it's almost 3-to-1 in the educational system. So if you're looking for an educated man, like God's looking for, or looking for someone who's about learning and doing something in the future, they are not attending colleges. Where are the men? Where are the men? Well, I looked around. They're not in the church house. They're not in the homes with their families. They're not working like they're supposed to be working. And let me tell you, if you're a grown man and don't have a job, you playing like you a man. Every grown man ought to be working somewhere, trying to earn some kind of power. I ain't talking no welfare, nigga. I'm not talking no joke of sitting around waiting on the system to pay for your children and buy baby for your big head boy while you sit at home playing Nintendo too much. You a man up. I'm not talking to you. I'm talking about men who understand. What makes you a man is that you refuse to let the government do what you're supposed to do in the first place. Where are all the men? That's why the men, they don't have time for petty arguments and fussing about whose football team won and whose football team lost and what they're talking about. When somebody gonna do something for me, a man will stand in the gap and make up the hedge, meaning that when you don't do something for me, I'll get up and do it for myself. Where are the men this morning? Why can't we have men who are mature enough to understand that building the kingdom of God is damn important? Why is it important? Because in verse number 31, the Bible says, if I don't find a man to get this work done, I will pour out my indignation upon the world. Let me tell you something. As soon as man got out of his role and position with God, in every case in the scriptures, God rained down fire from the heavens. So y'all with me right quick. When Sodom and Gomorrah, given to homosexuality, could not find 50 men, could not find 40 men, could not find 30 men, could not find 20 men, could not find 10, 5 men. So the Bible said Lot left and it rained fire and brimstone from heaven. We need men on the same America this morning. That's why we look for leadership. That's why we look for men who are standing in the gap. Men need to understand that one of our problems is because we're out of position. We now have a bad disposition. Because I realize as a man, I'm supposed to be at this point and place in my life, but because I've been acting like a boy, I'm still sitting over here on the sideline, hating on everybody else who are man enough to face their challenges. Are y'all with me right now? I'm talking to 5 people here full of Holy Ghost right now. And watch it. So let me remind you who you are. Number one, a man is not somebody that is beating his wife at home. He's not a man that is allowing somebody else to take care of his children. He's not a man that sits around and is an expert of the welfare system and want to work it better than before we put it together. He's not walking around trying to find somebody with 5 or 6 kids that's on hood so they can move into the house and try to take over something. That's a scoundrel. And that's a ratchet man. He's ratchet. He's sitting around taking welfare money, buying expensive booze. There's something wrong with that. Right now, help me. The kid, you got my back, but he won't be mad at this morning. If they anybody move you. All right. Okay. So am I? All right. Amen. I need that. And so the church then and the church now have a problem that God's looking for men, not because they can't find it, but man has left his place. Number one, I need to remind you that a man realizes that God has blessed him. He realizes that in Genesis 1:28, that something was said to mankind. And remember this now, it was said to mankind, it was said to both man and woman. Are you listening to me? It wasn't just said to me, but it was said to me and woman. I'm almost able to get through when I make this point right here. Because whenever man is not in his place, the woman will step up whining, lazy, swindling, ashy feet, unwashed hair, sitting around and talking about you running something. Folk only gonna be hungry for so long before they get them something to eat, my say, amen. And it's so bad that some women, and I'm not saying this right, because men out of their place can't find a man, they turn to woman. Leadership position. Women have stepped into men's leadership position. The government has stepped into your position, raising our children, telling them how to discipline your child, telling them what you can do and can't do to your child. You need to put them in time out. I'm the man that's out. I'm going to whip his butt, and you can do what you have to do after that.
Don't think she don't know how to lead.
And an intelligent woman will never follow a up in my house and look at my drink. I don't know if I want a drink.
Okay.
I wouldn't be saying no new friends. Amen. Y'all with me so far? Now watch your mouth. He said, take it and do what to it? Subdue it. And then do what? Have dominion over it. This is not an ungodly man, but it literally means that you have a responsibility to the manship of your house. You have a responsibility to the community in which you live in. You have a godly responsibility to the children that you bring into this world. You know something, if we really, really get serious about this rally of men, every man in here that's on the system in some fraudulent way, you go out of here today and get off the system and work 3 jobs you have to and be a man and take care of your house.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. I don't get a whole lot of pepper for that. That's all right. But I'm trying to help somebody.
Amen.
God says that if there is a time and a space in which I have given you dominion over the fowls of the air, the things that are in the sea, and every creepy thing that crawls. We have no been letting snakes run us around in our own house. I have given you authority to name and claim this stuff for you to rule over. And after the fall, God said, even in your household, you are the head of your house. But we've left the house. 18 million people have homes without fathers in them, added to the bureau because men is out of position. Men is out of position because men have left God. Revelation 2 and verse 4, they left their first love. And some of them never come to God. And men are out of position because they left the church. And when you leave the church unprotected and the hedge is not covered and the gap is not taken care of, all kind of stuff will go on in the church house. All kind of foolishness will happen. And that's why we have so many churches, because there are not enough folk who have the God-given talent and ability that should be preaching the word of God that sit on the side. What God would have you to do.
Yeah.
I keep saying, I'm going to say again, that whenever we're not in our position, God is warning us that one man will take the position. Something will move when something's out of position. Look, if you will, at Exodus chapter 4 and verse number 25. Let me make my point soundly clear. In Jewish customs, it was the custom of a male to take his son on the 8th day and to circumcise him. But because the foreman could not find the man to do his job, the Bible says that she did the job for him. Can I make it plain to you? All right, Pat, you read it, and we'll make human application. This Exodus 4, verse 25, the Bible says what?
Then Zipporah took a sharp stone. And cut off the foreskin. Of her son.
Why? Read.
And cast it at his feet.
All right.
And said. Surely a bloody husband. Now to me.
She said, listen. If I had a man. Y'all know this too. You have never been at your house and something needed to get done. You had to do it yourself. Amen.
Hallelujah.
You had looked at the condition of your house and your children and your family and said, I got a problem. I'm running the house because you ain't man enough to run the house. Brother, y'all look at me funny. Zipporah had a man that wasn't in his place, had the wrong disposition, out of position, and she did the work for him. Are you saying this right? I'm simply saying to you that a woman knows how to lead and she's not going to fall in the cylinders, nor will she wait on you to be a man. And then you'll find folk doing stuff that you ought to have been doing in the first place. And so the question this morning is, will you come back to your house and set your house in order? Joshua said, Joshua 24, didn't no woman tell Joshua what he was going to worship and then tell him how she's going to worship? She didn't tell Joshua what you going to do. He said, as for me and my house. As for me and my house. No, I got to come with it. As for me and my house. Is that in your Bible? As for me and my house, we will do what?
Serve
God. Now hold on a minute. Remember, I pre-qualified so y'all wouldn't get all mad. I can qualify that I'm not speaking of this foolishness of male chauvinism of trying to run over folk and make folk do stuff. But I'm talking about godly spiritual leaders who would never hurt their spouse or family, but lead them in the way of Christ. When you have a godly man, then you follow a godly man.
Amen.
But somebody who's not godly, you have to turn him over to God. And God is looking for it. I'm looking for this morning. I'm looking for 10 men this morning that is ready to go to work for God in the body of Christ. I'm looking for 10 men who don't have time to be trying to figure out who the baddest and who's smartest and all this nail stuff and who dressed and all that kind of stuff. That's a whore. I'm looking for somebody that said, I'm going to be here on time. I'm going to help. I'm going to get out here and talk to folk, pray folk to Christ. I'm going to be a leader. I'm going to give. I'm going to support the work. I'm going to do what I need to do. And we're going to build this church, Brother Hamilton. God seeking a man that will come into the house of God and help expand the kingdom of God. Or there are 10 men that are tired of playing church and are ready to really be a part of the church. If the 10 men is ready to be a man, why don't you stand up and be a man this morning? Just stand up and be a man this morning. And I don't want the 10 that got up last week lying because you said you were coming last week. You didn't come back last week. I'm talking about 10 men that tell the truth. Who will stand up and address bad decisions that America has made, will declare, as it did during the Civil Rights Movement, from little churches amongst Southern Arabs, that civil rights must be. And now we will stand and declare that a marriage between a man and a woman is going to get hot, is going to get rough, is going to be tough, but you got to go and you got to subdue the man. Because God is looking for a man to deal with the adultery problems that this country faces today. I'm talking about a man that will now tell the truth on his income taxes. Tell the truth when it comes down to his welfare needs. Tell the truth to the school that you can pay that $2 for his bank lunches, but you've been working the system. That'll tell the truth that I'm the man of this house and I take care of the house myself. I'm talking about being a man this morning. And of character, and folk not going to like it. People not going to appreciate it. I'm going to add this to myself. So that whenever you have behavior intervention, there's a thing called intervention outbursts. You let your house go ragged for so long that when you come in and try to set the house in order, there's going to be outrage. Because you see, I've been talking back to you for 15 years.
Okay.
And you ain't never told me to shut up.
Yeah.
Why are you telling me, don't talk back to you now? My room been nasty for all 8 years of my life. I never picked up a pimple or a pair of socks, underwear, a shirt. My room stink and you ain't never said nothing. How come you had to go to that old church and come back up here and mess up a good thing? Why should I do it? And so the road will not be easy. Because when you start to deal with the behavior of the individual that they become accustomed to, they're going to fight you tooth and nail. That's why he said, go in the world and subdue it, take it. You got to go into that room and get some understanding and set the house in order, and you might have to sit by yourself for a while. You may be lonely for a little while, but if God be for us, God be for us, who can be against us? God is looking for men who knows that he's left to rule over his own house. He's looking for a man who understands he's left to provide for his house. God's looking for a man who understands that it's for him to help edify the kingdom of God. Ephesians 4, verse 11, he gave some apostles, gave some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors, some teachers for the edification of the church. God's looking for a man who understands that is not a time for fear. Alvin and Anthony, it's time for you to stand up to some folk around you. It's time for you to tell family, I love you, but who is my mother, my brother, my sister? He that doeth the will of my Lord and Savior, saved is my family and my kinsmen. Alvin and every brother here in Anthony, I want you to know that God can use a fearful leader. He cannot have a leader that wants to be popular with the rest of the world by foregoing the work of the Lord. Judges chapter 7 and verse number 3. The Bible said that he declared through the men of God. He said, look out amongst you, find you some men, and everybody that's fearful and everybody that's afraid, send them back to their own house. I stopped by to tell you that God is saying right now, if you worry about what folk gonna talk and say about you, how folk gonna run your name down, how folk gonna treat you when you take your standards up, he said, I can't use you in the kingdom of God. In fact, most women don't like a scary man. When somebody breaks in the house, they expect you to get up and take the bullet if necessary. He's looking for a man who was very frank and honest. Acts 5 and verse 29. When they were told to stop preaching the gospel of Christ, he said, we ought to obey men. We ought to obey God rather than men.